we presented together, and now we are quite a big group. The opportunity of being here is because we were invited to write an article for the International Journal of Social Research Methods, and we decided to do it not only, the journal was, the monograph was about teaching research methods, and we turned it out and we said learning research methods. And in this occasion, we were not thinking about how we make or promote students, especially postgraduate students, to learn research methods, but we took the advantage of reflecting and putting together all the trajectory of our group, and we were discussing with our group members to see how we have been learning research methods through our research time by doing research, not only in courses. So the first thing that came out is that for us, methods are not the problem. The problem is what is your positionality? What is your epistemology, your ontological, epistemological, and methodological position? Because methods can be used in many different ways, and the way you look at methods in relation with your positionality makes a big difference. We say that we don't collect data. In fact, we construct, we produce data, not only collect it. So for us, this is the first. The second is that methods can be used from, as I said, from very different different positions, from rather positivist, objectivist, reductionist, and statu quo research perspectives, as reflected in the mode one of knowledge production, or it can be used from a more constructionist, subjectivist, complex, participatory, and inclusive research position, like in mode two of knowledge production. For us, positionality is crucial. The most important thing is until the first dot. Positionality is vital because it forces us to acknowledge our power, privilege, and biases, just as we denounce the power structures that surround our subjects. We don't want to be feeling that we have the truth, that we are in the right position. We are always discussing. So we are always discussing our positionality, and through the way of doing research, we always add new views of our positionality. We stand by the moment in a constructionist approach, where we think that the social basis of knowledge and symbolic origins of reality, and we are moving now, we are since a couple of years, we are discussing this post-qualitative debate. We are also near the hermeneutic phenomenology as a foundation of the notion of experience, because in social sciences, experience of subjects is fundamental. The same fact can have totally different consequences from a person to another, and on the narrative of experience. For us, narrative research methods are a way of catching and giving account of these experiences that are very complex and highly contextual. We stand from a, as I said, from a social constructivist approach to granted theory, so that so we can address why questions while preserving the complexity of the social life. We are very careful about complexity. We can't make things simple because they are not. Somebody was saying for every complex question is a simple answer, and this answer is always wrong. And sometimes the complex are not totally right. For us, ethic is fundamental. We treat the other as a legitimate other. We thought that people that give us the time, the experience, have to be highly respected. And for us, more and more we involved people in, even in the decision making of what is the real problems, because sometimes we are in academia and we go there in a reality and set us our own questions without listening to the people that are part of the phenomena. The naturalistic and narrative methodologies such as ethnography, art-based research, biographical narrative forms of inquiry and ways of holding the complexity of human experiences are the base of our research projects. Sometimes, now no, because we are more known and respected, but when we started as young scholars, that we started with these new perspectives, sometimes we had problems because the people who were assessing our research projects didn't understand them because they have not done the reading of the literature we have done. Now it's much better because we have opened a big road. Also, very important, we held a non-totalitarian narrative strategy that enabled reflecting on the different sources and references collected through the different research methods to configure the narrative accounts. We don't want to close the accounts. We want to give the readers the possibility of making their own meanings, their own understandings. We present our, so to say, photo, what we have been able to catch up, but we want others to reflect upon it as a way of... And this is also very important. We have lots of discussions about if we do research to succeed academically only, or we want also do research for understanding and transforming. This is a big discussion because, for instance, it relates to the kind of papers or the kind of journals you address the results of your research. And this is because we think the phenomena are highly contextualized, and something that can be very meaningful maybe for scholars, it's not, for instance, for teachers. And we mostly do research on education, so for us it's very important that for them is also meaningful. And finally, for my part, because Fernando is going then to put a couple of examples of how we learn by doing research, we never ask others what we were not ready to do. What I mean by that? For instance, when we start a project, if we do life histories of teachers, we start by doing our own life history as teachers. Now we just started a project about how secondary school teachers learn out of the school and to which extent they use or they pass this knowledge to their school teaching. And we have, and we do learning cartographies. And we have started by doing our own learning cartographies. And we also make papers out of that. So now the question for this is how we learn about research methods while implementing research. And Fernando is going to tell you about, if I can put this out.
Okay, thank you, Juana. Before I need to say some words about my context, because I am not only a member of this group, I'm teaching in a College of Art, and I'm teaching a College of Art research methods. That is extraordinary for some people, because people suppose that in a College of Art, you don't do research. And in my case, I teach art-based research to the students, and the way I do is I invite the students to participate in a research project. That means I don't teach theoretically. Examples of this research are made sense of the experience of silence in the university class. One day, students say, well, we don't speak in our class. We could do a research about why we don't speak in our class. Or last year, the research was about student transitions in a contemporary knowledge capitalism and neoliberalism between being students and workers. And we do research about that. But we do research using ethnography methods and also using art-based research methods. That is important to me that learning is always through doing. It's not only reading books. From there, and as Juana was saying, this was our starting question. We want to know how doing research we learn about research method. And this, where the three questions, we put these three questions to ourselves and also to our colleagues. What does it mean to understand the research project as a continuing formation process? Aspects relating to learning of research methods in group. And tensions, this is very important. We think that if we don't talk about the tensions in a research project, we are leaving something very important outside. And tensions and inputs derived from developing and using innovative research methods, because the notion of innovative research methods for us is very important. And as we didn't want to do this in vacuum, we use our learning process in two projects that we were running at the same time. These are the two projects. One was called the construction of the professional identity of infant and primary school teachers during the initial professional development in the first year at work. That what means to follow and be together body to body with a group of infant and primary school teachers during practically 1 year, building stories together in the field and through conversations. And the other one was living and learning with new literacies in outside school, in this case, out secondary school, contribution for reducing school dropouts, exclusion, and abandonment among youth, because as probably some of you know, Spain is one of the countries in the European Union with the higher rates of dropouts. And in this context, we arise the three questions, and we start at the same time collecting what our colleagues say, but also trying to do that the post-Thalesian perspective to research say that is generate knowledge and thought for the evidence. Assuming that we never collect evidence, we collect sources, and what we do is we create the evidences. And this distinction for us is very important. We always create the data. And for example, from sentences like that from Paolo, a senior researcher, the most significant fact in my learning experience with Sfrina, that is the name of our group, is how I learn about new methods and paradigms through constant revision of concepts. Even when I think that I fully understand a method of a research paradigm, I am surprised to see that I have changed my understanding about it through doing research and discussing it. And from sentences like that, what we, for us, emerged was that learning research methods is not just a way of doing. That is, in some teaching classroom, people see to do research, and some books of sci emphasize the idea that a research method is something you do. It implies, above all, understanding the role in the way of knowing solved by inquiry. And that means that the idea is not what methods I use, is what is the purpose and what is the context where I'm using this method. Another idea is, and this is another sentence, but another senior research, learning research methods while implementing the research allows adapting to methodology, to the study characteristics and the process. However, it also adds a pressure taking into account the allocated research time. In Sbrina, I have learned research methods over which I have too superficial knowledge. And this is very important also for senior researchers, be involved of using and creating, and this is very important, not applying research method through the process. And this put you, and this is something very important for us, into the notion of unknown. For us, it's very important work and do research based on the position of unknown. Because if, as Juana many times said, if we ask what we really know, what is the purpose of doing a research? And the consequences of that is learning during the research process entails a dialectic process leading to test and evaluate in a practice what is happening with the methods we use. And this is something also fundamental, because all the time we are putting in questioning the methods we are using when we analyze and arise conversation through the research process. Something here that is important and is different for doctoral and master student that normally is a very individualistic and solitary process, that to do research together have a different completely perspective. To do research in group move many things, move emotions, create tensions, need to negotiate permanently, and this is why we talk about the dialectic of learning in research methods. Another sentence, this is from Judith, a junior researcher. From learning research methods in group, I value the exchange of ideas, sharing feelings, this is very important. Sharing feelings is not only an intellectual process. To assert myself sometimes with the help of others, and also disagree a lot. Consensus and dissensus are fundamental in the learning process. I don't know if we learn in groups. I know that I learn things working in the group. And this distinction is very important. Learning things working in the group. And for us, it arises to think about and explore and extend and connect with other voices, that learning methods is not an unidirectional and solitary issue. It takes place in the life of the group and is linked to projects. And this is, for us, the core, the center, the heart of what it means to learn research methods. We allocate a space in which the notion of learning is relational. And this is also very important, it's not individual, in a double sense between people and with research project access. Another sentence is from another junior researcher, because in our group it's a combination of senior and junior researchers, because it's for us the way of learning together. Writing papers with more experienced members has been key. Also, organizing events and attending to international conference, workshop, and symposia. And finally, the feedback to our text given by the peers review. I think all this movement is also a process of learning research methods. It's not only to apply in the research process, but it's also to go to conference, it's writing papers together, because it's going beyond the specific act of applying our research methods. And for these notions of this comment, of this statement, we thought that learning takes place in the process of shared writing. And this is something connected in some way with the previous presenter. A more invisible and less explored learning that allows embodying the lessons learned during the research process. For us, and this is also a consequence of our work with in our research group, is that the learning research method is not something that is practical or intellectual, it's embodied in yourself, in the body, in the relation with the other. And another for Judith, learning research methods while the project is carried out is very important part of the learning by doing. And this is it is a key notion. It also has a downside. Not knowing quite clear what are you going to do a priori before starting the research. And this is, it's some, a year ago, we gave a talk in Southampton University, and the topic of our talk was using risky methods in educational research. And the notion of risky for us is very important, because risky sometimes means that you imagine what you want to do, but you don't really know, and you are discovering through the process. And risky means also that not everything is under control. Sometimes you have the questions, but during the process, you need to change your questions. And for this, for us, is important, maintains an active tension between the known and the unknown. And in the research, in the learning process, for us, this is fundamental. And this is connecting with what I was saying. The main risks are related to the subjectivity nature of our methods. Sometimes we might end up with highly heterogeneous results due to the particular way each of us understands the methods, which take us to a lot of reflection and unified efforts. this tension is fundamental because you need to find a common meaning, and a common meaning is something that puts you in risk of confronting yourself with others. And for this, we assume risky research positions because we don't define the phenomenon to study before exploring it, do not impose predefined categories of analysis on the evidence. We generate in the process of the conversation, the process of exchanges, etc. And that's all. Thank you for listening, and now we are open for discussion.